What kind?
Oh, about a foot long, brown with speckles, freshwater fish, surplus to requirements.
Matter of fact, I am partial with a little bit of fish, yeah.
Radio West. I want to get a message to Eddie Shoestring.
I want you to tell Eddie Shoestring. Well, I've done time before, but this is different. I'm here for something I didn't do. My wife knows I didn't do it. The police know I didn't do it. I know I didn't do it. I'm innocent. And I need your help. Not just me either. There's...
Hello? Caller? Hello?
He didn't get any further.
Yeah, probably caught him at it.
His wife's phoned me several times as well.
Oh, you know what she's like. Petitions, vandalizing the town hall, going through a highly publicized nervous breakdown. Well, you've seen the clippings. What can I do for her?
She's done time. Got a bit of form. I think it's odds on he was guilty.
Well, except that when a man behind bars goes to the trouble of contacting me, I'm naturally intrigued.
Are you going to visit him?
There's always just the chance that he's innocent.
It's not my style, never could be. Yeah, of course I've used shooters as frighteners, always unloaded. The law knows that.
They've found some of the jewellery in your house. How's that for style?
They found a piece like it from another job. I shouldn't have kept it.
No, I haven't. What do you want me to do that your wife isn't already doing?
All right. I got you here under false pretenses.
You what?
Yeah, well, sort of. It's Mel I want to talk about. I'm scared.
Scared?
Yeah. Of what she might do. Well, I just feel that she's going to do something crazy.
Like what?
Do herself in. Oh, I know what you're thinking. Yeah, you think it's a put-up job between Mel and me. Well, it's not.
I just don't see what I can do. I mean, even if she is the way you say she is.
She just feels that she needs somebody to believe that I'm innocent.
And if I don't?
You're just like the rest of them.
Villains don't love their wives, don't love their kids, don't love their family. Do they? They don't care. They're just villains.
I mean, Harry never went into that jeweler's with a shotgun. And as for blasting away at the kid, no way. When you get to know something about a man you've been married to for 10 years...
Even if you spend half the time with the Nick.
All right. It wasn't Harry who killed her. I mean, not Harry. He wouldn't do that. He couldn't.
Well, the police think he did. Well, they proved it in court.
Police? What do you know about the police? He was just the next on the list.
I didn't know they kept a list for pinning murder.
Mel, they've still got that hotel order in it.
Nearly.
You ought to be on your way by now.
All I want you to do is put Harry's case on Radio West. I mean, it's the only way I can get anybody to listen. You can do that, can't you?
No, it's not up to me.
All you've got to do is tell your listeners the truth.
But I don't know the truth.
God, why is it so difficult?
Mrs. Shepherd, Harry seems to feel as the possibility...
Feel? Why don't you ask me how I feel? Talking to no-hopers like you.
Now, here's the delivery list. You go onto the registrar's, then to Willett's, and then you follow the van wherever he takes you until they're all finished. Do you understand?
Bye.
Bye.
That's right, Mr. Drake. I think he's doing a broadcast at the North Devon Boat Show tomorrow. Yes, I will. Goodbye.
Hello, I've brought the flowers.
Lovely. They're for?
They're for one of the director's offices.
Mr. Satchley. I didn't know he'd ordered any. I'll show you the way.
Yes? Yeah.
Your flowers, Mr. Satchley.
You're right. Love.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Reception.
This is Mel Shepherd.
Who?
The flower lady.
Oh, yes. What can I do for you?
I'm going out onto the roof.
I'm sorry.
I said I'm going out onto the roof.
What?
The roof, love, the roof.
Mrs. Shepherd? Hello?
Noon. yes, high noon on a foul summer's day in grey clouds in the sky. Let's hear a little footstep and country western sound now from the tonsils of that lovely, lusty lady, Philomena Quinn. How'd you like a piece of her pecan pie in the old chuck wagon?
Are you the flower lady?
That's a stupid bloody question.
Can I help you?
Look, don't come any nearer. Stay where you are. I'm going off this roof.
Yippee-yay, yes siree, Bob. Some piece of pecan pie. I'll be back for seconds, Philomena.
Mrs. Shepherd, please come away from the edge.
I'm staying here.
But why?
And you can send him away.
Hello? Police, urgent, please.
All right. Now, will you be sensible? Let's try to sort this thing out.
I saw Eddie Shoestring this morning. I thought he might help.
Yes, I know.
Look, it's quite simple. All I want to do is go on your radio and tell everyone how my husband's been wrongly convicted.
Right. All right. I can fix that for you. Why don't we go down to my office?
No. I want a microphone here.
Up here? Well, that's not so easy. You see, it would present some technical problems.
You better get it, or I'm going off.
Hello. We're looking for Eddie Shoestring. No? Well, if he does show up, can you get him to call here immediately, please? It's desperately urgent.
I find that hard physical work is the best form of relaxation. I'm enjoying your day off.
Is this boat ever going to sail? Or is it just your psychiatric couch?
Oh, you were pleased when I invited you.
Hey, that's you.
We all think it'd be a tremendous idea if Eddie knew just how much we'd like to see him back here at Radio West. No kidding. So, Eddie baby, if you're listening, here's a record just for you, one of your favorites. The voice of Paul Robeson, and nobody knows the trouble I've seen.
How much longer have we got to wait?
Just hang on, we're getting the right equipment. Put it on the deck.
Is that it?
Just pick it up and speak into it. You'll be okay.
How will I know if I'm on?
Get her ready as fast as you can.
Ticking by at 12:33. And now stand by for a special item. Someone here to talk to you. Special guest in our building, Mrs. Mel Shepherd.
I'll give you a cue.
Are you there, Mrs. Shepherd?
Thank you. My name is Melanie Shepherd. I'm speaking to you from the rooftop of Radio West. A year ago, you might remember, a girl assistant was shot dead in a
raid on a jeweler's shop. Everybody was shocked. It was such an unnecessary killing. So a killer had to be found. The only trouble is they got the wrong man. My husband, Harry. Now, somewhere, it is the man who really did it. Somebody knows who he is, and somebody knows where he is. Well, this is your chance. If you know anything, whether you're straight or not, now's the time to come forward. And if the guilty man isn't found, I'm going to throw myself off this roof.
Should have got authority before doing this, you know.
Jeez, what else could I do?
Anything. Pull the plugs, close down the transmitter.
She's got a radio out there to check that she's on the air.
Should have called us first.
If anyone tries to trick me, or tries to get me down by force, I'll jump straight away. That's it.
Yes, well, that was our special item. Thank you, Mrs. Harry Shepherd. And now, why don't we have some music while we try to deal with this very sad situation here at Radio West?
Tonight, my thoughts turn back.
Well, Mrs. Shepherd.
Hello, Mel.
Oh, no. Stay where you are.
Well, come on. This isn't going to get anybody anywhere.
Have you come to soft soap me as well? Well, don't. You're one of the reasons I'm up here.
Look, you can't seriously expect anybody to go out there and find him just like that. It's not possible.
Is anybody going to try?
Mel, listen, it's a big city. He's got to be looked for carefully. And can't... Please, will you just come away from there?
I said, is anybody going to try?
Excuse me. What are you going to do, Eddie?
I'm going to look for him. What else can I do?
The case is closed off the books.
There's a woman up there threatening to throw herself off. You must be kidding.
Look, laddie, we had another rape last night. This morning we had two robberies and a shooting.
Yeah, we got a nutter on the roof and a Mickey Mouse detective to cope with.
Listen, I've given my word. And the least you can bloody well do is help me.
She really means it.
Not if I can find the bloke that shot Janice Blake.
You'll never do it, Eddie.
Do you want to bet?
I wondered why you were closed.
Yes, well, you see, it's Yom Kippur.
Sorry?
You're supposed to be sorry. That's what it's all about.
Right. I don't quite know how to explain this, but there's a woman on the roof of Radio West, and I'm trying to...
We know.
Yeah, she had the radio on. We remember Janice. Poor dead girl.
Of course.
What can we do for you, Mr...
Shoestring. Sometimes, after a period of time, people remember things, just little bits of evidence.
Nothing we didn't tell the police. He had a hood on, off-the-peg clothes. Look, I was blind with fright. And as I did nothing to save Janice, the gun went off.
Maybe something keeps coming to me.
So you were in the shop as well?
Sometimes I help. No, it's the detective in charge of the case. That was almost as if he knew.
Knew what?
Well, I knew who the man was. Do you remember Sydney? The way he kept trying to, oh yes, force a description on us.
Yeah, the man's build, his voice, the way he walked.
Yeah, like I said, as if he knew. We couldn't help him, we couldn't be that definite.
Well, who was he, the detective? Do you remember his name?
Well, yes, it was in all the papers. The man they suspended over corruption, wasn't it?
Coleman. Colston. Colston, that was it, Colston.
Mrs. Shepherd? Yes? Aren't you cold?
No.
It's pretty blowy up here. Wouldn't you like a coat?
I know what you're trying to do. Don't.
You'll catch a cold.
Don't be so bloody silly. Go away.
You know who I am. I'm not a policewoman. Put it on. There's some more cigarettes and a lighter in one of the pockets. Would you like me to get you some coffee?
About the same here. Mrs. Mel Shepherd has given this city a few hours to produce someone who she believes is the real killer of 18-year-old jeweler shop assistant Janice Blake, murdered 6 months ago. Meanwhile, police have asked us to beg people not to come sightseeing around the Radio West building.
I thought someone would be around. I didn't think it'd be you, though.
Hello, Corson.
I thought it'd be one of my mates.
I want to talk to you about the Harry Shepherd case.
You know, the ones who ran as if I had cholera the minute there was a whisper against me.
Yeah, I know how you must feel, but...
You know nothing, Shoestring. You're just a radio detective. It's kid stuff. Like the rest of the rubbish they've put out. My wife used to listen to that bloody thing all day before she cleared up. You don't know what it's all about, son.
Superintendent, do you know Mel Shepherd?
What's she been up to?
She's on the roof of Radio West, threatening to throw herself off unless I can sort out this case.
You ain't got a chance.
Look, you had a strong suspect before you picked up Shepherd.
How do you know that?
Who was it?
Look, I couldn't prove his name then, and I couldn't prove it now. You're trying to land me in more trouble.
There's only you and me here. I mean, how can I ever prove I've spoken to you?
Johnny McGiven. Heard of him?
No.
It was his mark. The approach and the gun. Also, he's lost his bottle. Been getting nervous. Only a matter of time before that gun went off.
Where can I find him?
Try his social secretary.
Hey?
His wife.
Go on.
No, thanks.
You must have something. Please.
Do you think I'm stupid?
There's nothing in it, honestly. That would be even more stupid with you on the edge. Look. Put it down. And move back. I believe in what you're doing. Do you?
about your mama. Feel about your father.
Trying to be funny or something?
No. I'm looking for Johnny McGiven. And I'm in a hurry.
Get your neck broken.
Where is he?
Listen, Bonehead, I've got a pony on this game.
10, 15, 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, £24, 36 pence.
How's that?
Almost a pony, without the tail.
Johnny isn't here.
So I gather. But his wife thinks he is, so maybe I just better go back and phone her again.
Hold it. Why do you want to see him?
Bring you.
I wanted to, Mel.
You shouldn't have.
Now, why don't you come away from there, Mel? You've done it now.
I'm not moving.
I couldn't go on without you, love.
This is the only way. I've thought it over and over. I've tried every other kind of protest. They don't work.
Mel.
I couldn't live without you.
Well, it won't work. Not in a million years. You'll never find that geezer. It won't work.
Well, we can try.
Come on, come on, come on. Come on,
nice little outing for you, Shepherd.
You're lucky I'm cuffed.
Don't worry, old son. She won't jump. She's got the type.
Get on with him, Pat. Get in the van, Harry. Don't get yourself hurt. Get in. Get in, Harry.
Sergeant. Clear all these people back, right out of the way.
Right, sir.
Any chance of going up for a picture?
Oh, don't be bloody stupid.
Look, all of you, out of the way, right back. I want you all right back out of the way.
Radio West, 329 meters. And here, the drama of Mrs. Mel Shepherd, I'm sorry to say. As she stands on our roof, still maintaining the innocence of her husband, Harry Shepherd, who 1 year ago began a prison sentence for the murder of 18-year-old jeweler's shop assistant.
Sorry, it's important. Can I have a word?
Come on, McGiven, I'm in a hurry.
I know how you must feel. My apologies.
Just what the hell are you up to, friend?
It's not what you think. I'm Eddie Shoestring.
Shoestring?
Yeah, that's right. Steady.
A private detective?
I know what you're looking for, mate. Not me. Oh, no.
Some people think that you were the blagger in that jeweler's raid.
Me? Shoot a kid for 1,500 quid's worth of high street trinkets? Do me a bloody favour.
All right, how do you convince me that you were clean?
I don't believe I'm hearing this.
And I'll tell your wife what a rotten game of pool you play.
Okay. But I didn't do it. I'll tell you something else. Harry Shepherd couldn't do it.
Say that again.
not his style. Anyone will tell you that. Look, when it happened, everyone agreed whoever did it was a bloody maniac. We all turned narcs for a week, see if something turned up. When nothing did, the law framed Harry Shepherd. Framed him proper for a quick arrest. I'd help you if I could, Shoestring. For his missus' sake. Poor cow. Threatening to do herself in like that.
Then put your mind to it.
Well, it did occur to me at the time.
What did?
Getting rid of the stones, some of the other stuff.
A fence?
A fence. This bloke's more like the Berlin Bloody Wall.
Well, while you tell me, could you just get your lady here to pick up the phone and dial Radio West?
How did you get in here?
I get in all the best places.
Shouldn't you be rushing around playing hero rather than intruding here?
I thought I might add to your friend's entertainment.
I doubt it. Any idea who's here tonight?
Let me guess. Ones without chins are titled, and the ones with double chins are lawyers and MPs.
Right.
And the girl in the pool is Miss Westcountry.
My daughter. Perhaps you'd better go and talk in the drawing room. Now, maybe you'll explain why are you here.
Oh, come on, Mac, don't play the stiff lily-white shirt fronts with me. You might be able to fool this bunch, but I know what you really do.
My manservant, despite the delicate way he serves drinks, did in fact wrestle. They're not Olympic rules. Decidedly unsporting is Lacey. You could break your neck like a stick of celery. Now, what do you want to know?
The man I'm looking for stole some jewelry in the Harry Shepherd case. Now, either he must have sold it somewhere, or he's cooling it off.
Categorically, Shoestring. If that maniac had come to me, I'd have made sure he was grassed on.
Well, maybe you could suggest somewhere else he might have gone.
Nobody else. And take my word for it, nothing goes on that I don't know about.
Yeah, I believe you. Well, in a normal raid, would they hang on to the goods?
If I were you, I'd forget about the pickings and think more about the hardware.
I wonder what would happen if they could hear you now.
As I say, I have a daughter.
By hardware, you mean a gun?
Police here are tougher on unlicensed guns than anywhere else. Now, if the man who bought that shotgun couldn't get a clean piece, he'd only have one source. And when I've given you a name, I'd like to get back to my guests.
Alcohol last night and now this. I haven't eaten a meal at home since Tuesday.
Well, still, maybe it'll take the newspapers' minds off the rapists we can't catch in the Follett Street job. Here,
Ella. Thank you. It's Sonia, Mrs. Shepherd.
Yes?
I brought you something to eat.
Nothing like a rooftop scare, is there?
You catch those camera boys' faces. Those ghouls live for a jump. Wins him a prize or something. Mad bloody cow.
I know, it makes me dizzy just looking at her.
Diabolical.
Eh?
Liberty. Biggest one you will ever take, son.
I had to see you.
My family is private, son. Bother any of them again, I'll see you get blown away.
Right, now I've got your commercial out of the way, can we get on with it?
Steve.
Joy smashing you into the ground one day.
Well, private detectives don't carry guns in this country.
Been known to carry tape recorders.
Look, all I'm trying to do is save a life. Now, did you sell anyone a gun just before that girl was murdered?
Sawn-off shotgun.
So you remember?
Every gun I remember.
Did you get a name?
Joking.
Well, what did you look like?
Moustache, glasses, young, ordinary.
Anything else about him?
Well, selling a gun, I don't notice faces that much. Also, I don't have a face.
Right. You've been a great help.
One thing. A thought.
Yeah?
The young theory about that jeweler shop job. Maybe you meant to kill her.
What?
Don't buy a sawn-off shotgun for a pygmy shop raid. It makes sense. Ask this bloke what sort of a shooter he wanted for what sort of a job. Never said what the job was. Just asked for the shotgun to make sure. That was his words.
You mean everybody's been on the wrong track?
We've all assumed that Janice Blake was killed because of the robbery. What if it was the other way around? What if the robbery was a cover for killing the girl?
An 18-year-old shop assistant?
But
why?
That file you told me about, was there anything in it about the girl? A boyfriend, associates, anything?
She had a boyfriend, yes, but he wasn't questioned. Why should he be? Eddie? Eddie! Would you like some soup, Mrs. Shepherd? Or how about another jumper?
Just go away. A lot of you.
I'm sorry to bring you downstairs at this hour.
It's all right. What can we do for you?
I want you to go back to the day Janice was killed. I want you to go over it with me. Now, where did she usually stand?
Well, here. She's still here.
Right, okay. Now, was there anything different about her that day? Did she seem frightened or upset or as if she'd had a row?
No, she was just the same Janice as always.
Nice, quiet girl.
I remember teasing her because she wasn't doing the crossword.
Yes, she always did the crossword.
Is it too hard for you, I asked her. Well, I remember now, she was doodling instead.
Yeah. Doodling what?
She was doing something to a picture of the newspaper. She was drawing a moustache and glasses on it. It's one of those photo fits.
And then she asked if she could use the phone to call her boyfriend, Charlie. He worked at the newspaper.
That's all right. There's always somebody on duty.
The morning Janice was killed, she phoned you. What was it about, Charlie?
I wasn't in. Someone left a note on my desk.
What did she say?
That she thought she'd found out who the rapist was.
You didn't tell the police?
Of course I did. They said they get 50 calls a week like that. Anyway, they were just about to charge Shepherd.
Look, the morning she was shot, she was doing this. Now, does this remind you of anyone you know? Well, come on!
Well, it's like someone... She must have been mistaken.
Look, in this situation, anything is possible. Who the hell is it?
It's a guy who works here.
on Charlie's desk, didn't you? Couldn't take the chance that she was right, could you? You were even taking pictures of the radio station.
Come on, I've got him, Mel. Come on. It's all right. Got him. Come on, Mel. Mel, come on, just relax.